Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Pen Pal with Me video. This video is going to be a bit different than the other ones because I'm trying new things on my channel. I'm trying to see what works better for me, and I already changed a couple of things on my bullet journal setup for May. In case you didn't watch it, it's here. But now I'm going to do something different for my Pen Pal with Me videos because the normal ones that I've been doing are not really working for me anymore. So yeah, let's try something new today. So first off, today we have a sponsor from a small business, which is Shupadoodles. They sent me some sticker sheets, notepads, a washi tape, and a planner. And oh my god, I don't know if you're going to see my studio vlog before this video or not, but I'm just going to show you the stationery that they sent me, and on my studio vlog I'm going to show you the planner and everything. But they kindly sent me these, and I'm just going to show you a little bit of everything. I'm going to do a Pen Pal with Me video with their stationery as well. For this Pen Pal with Me video, I'm going to try to do a envelope inspired by this sticker sheet, and I'm going to use some of their deco stickers and notepad because they sent me all of this, and I really want to try to use everything to come up with a pink, red-ish strawberry theme. This is a shop based in Australia, and they have a bunch of products, and I am really excited to just show you the things that I got, but I definitely recommend checking their TikTok because they post a bunch of content and you can have a better idea of how many products they have because it's amazing. So I'm going to use this sticker sheet and this notepad. This notepad is really pretty, and I don't know if they have this in other colors, but they should really have the same colors as their deco stickers because this notepad is really pretty, and I really like the thick grids. It's really, really pretty, and I'm going to use one for the envelope maybe, at least that's the plan. We also have this washi tape with a bunch of sushi or Japanese foods. I don't really know the term, but it's really cute, and it's kind of this salmon color with all of the little things, which is going to be so pretty to send to my pen pals and to use in envelopes and journaling. It's not the first time that I get a washi tape from a small business, but it always feels so like unique to have it because it was like a single person creating it, and it's so funny. I'm also going to have an unboxing and a haul on a studio vlog. If I already posted that, it's going to be in the description, but if not, stay tuned for that. But yeah, now I'm just going to create an envelope for Jada with these pink stationaries from Shupadoodles, and I'm just going to grab other stuff to make the envelope with. And what's different about this video is that I already made the whole pen pal thing except for the envelope, and that's kind of the thing that I'm trying to do differently right now, because filming a full Pen Pal with Me video is really tiring for me and it takes a long time. So maybe if I just do the envelope on camera and I show you the other things that I included, maybe it works better for me. When I watch Pen Pal with Me videos, I always like to watch the collages for the envelope, and the rest is just like I just skip to the end. So yeah, you just need to see what I included in the pen pal. Maybe you don't need to watch the whole thing. That's kind of my idea from now on for these videos. So let me know at the end of this video if you really enjoy this type of video, because I'm going to show you everything that I did for the pen pal except like the whole process, because that's something that I can easily do off camera and I feel like that's better for me. So that's what I'm trying right now. And since I hit burnout and I'm now on a kind of a creative break, I try to understand what works better for me and what makes me really tired from filming, because I have a job and I'm studying. So I don't really have the time to do a whole letter on camera. If I can just cut it short but keep it interesting, I think that works better for me. Now I'm also grabbing some washi tape. I don't really know what I'm going to do for this envelope yet, but I just want to grab a few things just in case I get inspiration to do something. And I'm also going to grab some deco stickers just to see if they help me with whatever I'm thinking about doing. One thing that my break really helped with was to kind of get loose and not really be afraid of using stickers. And it kind of sounds weird to say that, but I have a ton of stickers and I never want to use any of them because I'm afraid to use them and not save them for a better time. I think I mentioned that on my May setup, but I just don't remember, because now I just create things and I try to like understand that if I want a specific sticker for this envelope, I'm just not going to be afraid of using it, because that's stupid. So yeah, that's something that my break really helped with. So we have three choices of envelopes. I have the white one, but last month I did a red and pink pen pal letter in a white envelope, so I don't know if I want to do that again. We have a big craft one, which I think it works well because these stickers have some brown elements on it, so maybe this will work. And I also grabbed the black one because I feel like it's going to be pretty fun to have like a dark background, but maybe not. So I'm going to go for the brown one. So I first want to see where I'm going to implement this notepad page. The idea that I'm having is to grab the notepad pages and to do like the whole thing covered in them, but match the little frames around it. I really want to try that because I really like how these look, and maybe they will not look like a Frankenstein envelope. So let me just focus and try to see if this works. Okay, I'm actually surprised that the Frankenstein attempt worked. I don't like this line right here because it's not really stuck to the other paper, and that's my fault. But because I'm going to put some stickers on top, I'm going to cover this part and hopefully this, so that's fine. But this was the idea that I had in mind, like have the border around it. And I think it turned out really nice. That's what I wanted. Now, I just need to figure out how I'm going to include all of the other things, because I still want to include this and some deco stickers. So yeah, I have to plan how am I going to do that. I wanted to use one of these watercolor sticky notes. I just don't know which color I should use. I think I'm going to go with the second one. And I kind of just want to cover this part right here with something. We'll see. I have here a ton of washi tape that I can use, so maybe I can put something over here. And this one is from Notebook Therapy, from the Sakura Journey collection. Yeah, I think we can do that. So I'm going to maybe cut this. And here's the thing, I normally plan out everything that I do for my pen pal videos, but since my break, I've just been so, like, I don't really care if things turn out differently than what I had planned. I just don't plan everything to the detail anymore, because that made me, I don't want to say anxious, but I was really stressing out over the art that I was doing, and nowadays I'm just like, no, I want to use this, I'm going to use it. I don't really care. I'm just going to cut off the outline for this so I can blend better. I didn't ask you any questions on social media for this video because I already have some topics that I wanted to cover. I saw a comment the other day on my video that I did, like, about how to spice up your pen pal letters, and someone asked, like, what do you write when your pen pal, like, doesn't talk much on the letter? And I was like, what do you mean? Like, some people are not going to be as extroverted. So, like, maybe ask questions. I had a pen pal a couple of years ago that she didn't really talk much, and I was the one making the whole conversation. And it was just, like, her whole letter was just like 20 lines talking about her day and stuff like that, and I kind of lost interest in her because of that, and we ended the exchange. But, you know, not everyone is going to be extroverted, and maybe that's a problem, but yeah, I don't know, like, maybe ask questions, see if the person can open up a little bit. That was at least what I did, and it worked for a while, but she was just not interesting. I kind of don't want to say that, but that's true. She was not that interesting to talk to, so we just kind of ended the communication. And on the other hand, like, I have pen pals that write a lot, and sometimes I know that I have to take an hour to read letters, just because they write so much, so you have both ends when it comes to pen paling. But try to make good questions, like, how was your day, or how are things with school or job, if they like a specific genre of music or movies, ask them if they saw that movie or if they like listen to that artist. Sometimes through their questions and answers you can start a conversation about a topic that you have in common. That's kind of what I do. I have some pen pals that I just talk about tattoos or movies or a specific artist, and it's so funny because we don't really talk about anything else except music or anime. Cut off these little strawberries because I kind of want to use that. I'm just confused about what I should do next because this is too pinkish and I kind of want to add darker stuff. I feel like I should use this one right here because it matches with this one, so I'm gonna cut it off. Yeah, I think this works better because it has some contrast. Also have to think, like, about their name. But I actually got some letters from AliExpress. I got these ones. And I can easily write here Jada with these, because these ones are kind of aggressive. Okay, I actually like how it turned out. And I wanted to add this sticker here, maybe? I'm really confused. I don't really know what I'm doing. I feel like the white space is kind of triggering me. Looks a bit better. Something is missing there, especially. here is the finished envelope. I feel like it's too minimal for my liking, but I included a bunch of products from Shippa Doodles, and I have just this washi tape from Notebook Therapy and these little strawberries that are from a sticker sheet from Stationery Paul. I'm going to leave everything down below, but I really like how it turned out because it's really minimal. But I also feel like I caught the essence of Shippa Doodles' designs. So yeah, I'm really happy with how it turned out, actually. Oh, and these letters are from AliExpress, and this little watercolor sticky note is from Stationery Paul as well. Okay, so making the envelope was the first part of this video, and now I'm just going to put everything together to send to Jada. So, first off, I'm going to grab this paper bag from Pau's Art Nook, from the things that they sent me, and I'm going to put all of the goodies here inside. This is what I created for the letter. It has a bunch of strawberries and some reds, and I actually did a spare page that she can use for whatever she wants. So if she wants to write a letter in here, she can. I am not sending Jada any questions because we've been pen pals for 2 years, so yeah, we just write letters to each other, but I'm sending her a this or that paper, and this washi tape is from the washi tape shop, and these stickers are from Notebook Therapy's collection Sakura Journey, and I'm also going to send her a playlist. For extras and goodies and stuff like that, I'm going to send her this postcard. For washi samples, I'm sending her just these three. These were gifted to me, these two are from Notebook Therapy. This one is from the Moonlight Blush collection, and this one is from the Sakura Journey collection as well. I'm also sending her some stamps from the Sakura Journey collection. I normally love doing this for my pen pals. I just take the stamp washi tape from Notebook Therapy and I swatch all of the stamps. So if they want to use one, it's not on a roll. They can just see the one that they want to use, cut it out, take out of the tracing paper back, and use the stamp as a sticker. And this one is the Four Seasons one, which is a new washi set that I got from Notebook Therapy. Really glad I got it because it's so cute. I really like all the characters and the little stamps. Really cute. I also like to include a Frankenstein sticker sheet. So these are all stickers from different sticker sheets that I got, either gifted to me or that I bought, but that I don't see myself using. So instead of sending incomplete sticker sheets, I take all of the stickers out and I put them in a Frankenstein type of sticker sheet. I also stamped all of the stamps from the Sakura Journey collection for Jada because I feel like she likes a lot of flowers and pinks and stuff. So I just sent her some of these so she can cut out and use as stickers. I did that on my video that I did with Notebook Therapy. So yeah, this is a good way if you have stamps to send them to your pen pals. Then I'm just going to send her a bunch of ephemera and post-its and stickers. This is normally what I include for all of my pen pals. So yeah, these are things that match her letter and things that I also see Jada using. And since we created an envelope now and I had some things that are leftovers, I'm also going to send these to her. By the way, if you're wondering how I pack my letters, it barely fits. Amazing. If you're wondering how I pack my letters, I actually have a live stream that I did on Instagram that you can watch on YouTube on my channel, explaining how I pack all my letters and where I put the addresses and everything, because I don't use this envelope as the outside envelope for the stamps from the post office and addresses and everything. So if you'd like to know how I do all of that, you can watch that live stream, and I believe this is not going to fit. I should have grabbed another bag, but I also don't want to. So you're going to make it work. Nice. See, I have to fit this in here. And this is barely going to close, but it's done. We don't care. Add this here. And because this is just going to be the envelope inside a white one, I'm just going to leave it like this. And this is my letter for Jada, which is pretty thick. Pretty thick, but really compact. So I really hope you enjoy this different type of pen pal with me video. I really have fun making this envelope for Jada with Chupadoodles stationery. I really hope you liked the envelope and how it turned out. Even though it's a little bit Frankenstein, I really like how it turned out. And make sure to check out Chupadoodles social media and website down below. Let me know what you think about these videos, because I really prefer to make videos like this. They are really easy for me to do. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. You can leave a strawberry emoji in the comments if you watched it until this point. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.